इलास्ट्रोसाइडेड इन एसी सर्किट विथ प्योर रेजिस्टेंस एवरेज पावर इज ई आर एम एस इंटू आई आर एम एस, करेक्ट ना? वॉट इज फॉर्मूला फॉर ई आर एम एस? ई आर एम एस फॉर्मूला, हेलो, वॉट इज फॉर्मूला फॉर ई आर एम एस? ERMS formula, next in there, show that in an AC circuit with pure inductor current lags by 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. So this is a coil of inductor L connected across alternating source. I is instantaneous current. We have to check that it is lagging by 90. Consider an inductor L to be connected across an AC across an alter Netting source of EMF E equals to E0 sine omega t. Please copy this much bit diagram. Consider an inductor L to be connected across alternating source of EMF E equals to E0 sine omega t. Can I clear this now? Hello, can I clear this?
Yeah, sure.
So we want to check whether current is ahead or behind or together. We have to prove here current is lagging by 90 degree. By Faraday's and Lenz's law, EMF induced across inductor, comma E dash is minus L di by dt. But by Kirchhoff's voltage law, what is total voltage of the system? Total voltage of system by Kirchhoff's law, is it zero?
Zero, yeah.
So E plus E dash will be zero. That means E will be minus E dash. So it is minus of minus L di by dt. Therefore, E equals to L di by dt. Please copy till equation 2.
Done, sir.
E is L di by dt. We are interested in current. So I'm just cross multiplying. Di will be equals to E upon L dt. Therefore, di is E0 sine omega t dt upon L. So integration of di is E0 upon L integration of sine omega t dt. Integration of di is I, E0 upon L, sine is minus cos omega t upon omega plus C dash, where C dash is constant of integration. Okay, please copy again till this. You got as E equals to L di by dt. From that, di equals to E by L dt. And then di is E naught upon L sine omega t dt. Integral of di is E naught upon L integration sine omega t dt. I equals to minus E naught upon omega L cos omega t.
Done, sir.
Just see. What is cos omega t? Is it sine 90 minus theta? Sine cos theta is sine 90 minus theta, correct?
Yeah.
So if I interchange this angle, that means minus omega t minus pi by 2 will do. Sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So this will come out. Finally, it will become E0 upon omega L sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Let I naught equals to E naught upon omega L. Therefore, I equals to I naught sine of omega t minus pi by 2. So if you look at equation 1, which is E equals to E0 sine omega t, and equation 3, which is I equals to I0 sine omega t minus pi by 2. So can I say in an AC circuit with pure inductor, current is lagging by 90 degree? Hello?
Yeah, sir.
This is a minus game, na? Minus means lagging. Minus 90 is lagging by 90 degree.
Lagging by 90, right.
So right. From here, please copy till end. From 1 and 3, we can say that current lags by pi by 2 radian or 90 degree in AC circuit with pure inductor. In AC circuit with pure inductor.
Done, sir.
Graphical representation of E and I in inductor with respect to omega t. Omega t, this is E or I, plus E naught plus I naught minus E naught minus I naught, here 0. This will be pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. When x is 0, that means when omega t is 0, for EMF it is 0. At 90 it will become maximum. 0. Negative 0. So EMF is a sine function. E0 sine omega t. E0 sine omega t. Now when time is 0, current is lagging, so it will come on negative side. Then 0. Then it will become positive. Then it will come to 0. Then it will become negative. So
So this is graphical representation of current. It is coming after voltage. This one is current and this is EMF graph. Draw properly.
Done, sir.
Phasor diagram. In phasor diagram, always EMF is taken first at angle omega t with x-axis. Length of ray indicates peak value. This is omega t. So E equals to E0 sine omega t's instantaneous value. Now current and voltage. Current will lag by 90. Lagging by 90 means in clockwise 90 degree from E0. Clockwise you have to draw at 90 degree from E naught. So this is pi by 2. This one is I naught. This is instantaneous value. So if this is pi by 2, then this will become omega t minus pi by 2. I know. Now see, this component and this component are same. Pi by 2, this total is how much? 90 only. So this is pi by 2, this is omega t. So this angle will be what? Pi by 2 minus omega t. This angle, correct?
Yes.
So this side we will take as I equals to I naught sine of pi by omega t minus pi by 2, that indicates it will become negative. That means it is opposite. Copy that. Understood now what we did? See, this side is minus. So when you interchange, you will get pi by 2 minus omega t, minus will come out. Matlab idhar aayega niche minus mein. See, if I write I0 sine of minus of pi by 2 minus omega t, matlab minus I0 sine of pi by 2 minus omega t, wohi aayega na idhar. That's why we have written this. Done.
Done.
Note. We wrote E naught upon omega L as I naught. Correct? Same we wrote or different thing we wrote? In this derivation, just check what we wrote. E naught upon omega L we wrote as I naught.
Yeah.
So E naught upon I naught. Can I write omega into L?
Yes.
If I divide by root 2 numerator as well as denominator, then this will become E RMS upon I RMS equal to omega L. What is voltage upon resistance? Voltage upon current. This is
resistance.
Voltage. It is actually then in the format of resistance if I compare with Ohm's law. Called as inductive reactance. This ratio is called inductive reactance. So we can define now like this. The resistance offered by inductor to alternating current. The resistance offered to inductor to alternate current is called as inductive reactance, or it is defined as the ratio of RMS EMF to RMS current through inductor. It is given by X suffix L equal to omega L. Because it is resistance, what will be its SI unit? What will be unit of XL because it is resistance?
Ohms.
Ohms denoted as omega. Now copy full from here note. Note, then inductive reactance, then that top. Done.
Yes, sir.
One more note. For DC source, F equal to 0. Therefore, XL, which is omega L, will become 2 pi FL, that is 2 pi 0 into L becomes 0. That means the inductor in DC source behaves as a connecting wire of negligible resistance, that is, if this is coil, this is resistance connected across DC source, then it will behave like just a connecting wire with no resistance. So only this resistance will be taken into consideration. Write note and draw diagram to understand numerical how you are going to solve.
Done, sir.
So we did pure resistor, we did pure inductor. Now we'll come capacitor. Show that in an AC circuit with pure capacitor, current leads by 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. Current leads by 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. So this is capacitor C connected across alternating source giving instantaneous current I. We have to show that I will be I0 sin omega t plus 90. So first part I am just writing, then I will explain. Consider a capacitor C to be connected across an alternating source of EMF equals to E0 sin omega t equation 1. Draw diagram and copy till this. Then let I be the instantaneous current.
Done, sir.
So current through capacitor, we have to check it is leading the EMF by 90 degrees. Current I is rate of flow of charge, and charge we know it is nothing but voltage into capacitor. Since C equals to Q upon V, so in place of Q we can write C into here voltage is E. So I equals to C constant d by dt. Therefore I equals to C constant d by dt of E is E0 sin omega t. Therefore I equals to C E0, derivative of sin is cos omega t into omega. So I equals to E0 omega into C cos of omega t. So I equals to E0, this can be written as 1 upon omega c. Omega c I wrote 1 upon omega c.
cos omega t. Therefore, I equals to E naught upon 1 by omega c sine of 90 plus theta. Because sine of 90 plus theta is also cos theta. And there is no change of sign here. That means plus will remain plus. So I can say let E0 into 1 upon omega c be I naught. So I becomes I naught sine of omega t plus pi by 2. Now from 1 and 2, can you say the current is leading by 90 degree? Thus, from 1 and 2, we can say that current in pure capacitor leads EMF by 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. Any doubt? Simple. I is dq by dt, q is ec, that is d by dt, e is e naught sine, then by maths. C as it is, e naught is constant I brought outside, sine derivative is cos omega t into omega. Then this omega c I wrote 1 upon 1 by omega c, because we require this in the format of voltage upon resistance later on. Clear? Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
So from 1 and 2, we can say that in pure capacitor, current is leading. If it is pure resistance, then current and voltage are in phase. Pure inductor, current is lagging. Pure capacitor, current is leading. Copy from I equal to.
Done, sir.
So thus in AC circuit with your capacitor, current is leading the EMF by 90 degrees. Graph of E or I versus omega T in capacitor. Omega T, E or I plus E naught plus I naught minus E naught minus I naught, this is 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. So first 0, then maximum 0, negative, back to 0. So this is variation of EMF. Now current. Current is leading by 90. So this is 0, then this is maximum, becomes negative, 0, then negative, back to 0, again positive. This is variation of current. EMF current. Draw diagram.
Answer.
Phasor diagram. X, Y, E naught at omega t, so E equals to E0 sine omega t. Then current is leading by 90. So it will be ahead by 90 degree. I know. Draw the diagram.
Done, sir.
at that vertical one, I naught sine omega t plus I naught.
So that's all for today. Now next part, next lecture will be almost chapter getting over. So Wednesday again lecture same time.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Same time is okay, na? Or 8:30?
Yeah, sir.
Comfortably 8:30 if you are having problem.
Not issue. Okay,
no, sir. No, sir.
Time is okay. Okay, we'll start at this time.